Our next inductee initiated multiple internet firsts for Singapore, including the first, here comes another word, WAIS is what I'll just say, server in the region, recognized leader for Tamil website. Please welcome Tan Tin Wee.
It is indeed a great honor, and I'm indeed humbled to stand before an audience of internet greats and internet luminaries. I feel so undeserving, and as they say, the more you reward the undeserving, the harder they will work in the future. So I feel that I will have a lot of more work cut up for me going ahead in the future. There are, of course, many, many, many people I need to thank, as Lynn mentioned. There are so many of us who were involved in constructing this incredible global edifice that will stand the times of history. And we've basically created something never in the history of mankind, as Jimmy Wales puts it very well, that the sum total of human knowledge can now be accessible by everyone. So it's indeed an incredible honor for me to receive this, to be inducted into this Hall of Fame. As Lynn said, it was indeed many, many people. And I'm gratified to know that there are at least two ladies who are in the midst of the first inaugural Hall of Fame. And as somebody used to say, it's really too many. And I hope that going forward in the future, we will have more people in the communities that are underrepresented coming forward to serve the internet cause. I really miss the days when one of my internet elders or mentors remarked to me when I asked him, why are you doing all these things for free? So one of the things I really missed was that internet spirit of voluntarism. People get really rich these days. I saw the slide which Professor Kleinrock showed, you know, billionaires at the bottom this morning. And I really felt that this was something that we need to bring back again, that internet spirit of voluntarism, to look after those who are less privileged than us, those people who are underprivileged, those people who did not enjoy the benefit of an education as we have, and to really reach out to the disenfranchised. And it was for that reason that I was always involved in helping some of the minority groups as chairman of the APNG, the Asia Pacific Networking Group that gave us APNIC. I was involved in one of the early helpers to promote internet for Asian women. I was involved for some time helping people with disabilities to get on the net. I was involved in helping at one time people who were not speaking English get web content in on the web, involved in the multilingualization of the web as well as the internationalization of the domain name system. So I was always fired with this enthusiasm of that spirit of internet voluntarism to help those people who need internet more than we ourselves. So it's indeed a great honor to stand before this august audience of internet luminaries, and also to maybe share that going forward into the future, I think we should be expanding even beyond the internet planetary, the planetary system of the internet, as Vint Cerf used to put it, that we should even go beyond that. And I stand here as I used to be a professor in biochemistry, before I was sucked in by Dr. Teo Ho Tong, my former boss, into the things internet in the 90s. And I've gone back to become a professor in biochemistry, working on bioinformatics and computational biology. So I'm quite the odd one out here amongst these internet engineers and network professors. But I like to highlight the point that all living things, for eons, are living things because they process information, and they've developed over eons the ability to transfer information from one place to another, from one organism to another. And we, in a sense, in the internet community, are just reinventing something that nature has already invented a long time ago. But of course, in a different form, we have carbon chemistry, and of course, most of us dealing with silicon chemistry. But point here is that we are increasingly beginning to be able to read that source code of nature through tremendous advances in genomics, for instance, proteomics, and so on. We're able now to read that source code of life. And we will see increasingly going forward into the future this convergence as well of biological information and digital information. And I really sincerely hope that I will live long enough, hopefully as long as my grandfather, who just passed away not so long ago at 101, that perhaps I may have that honor and chance of seeing yet another level of integration and convergence, and that of fusing biological information with digital information that we in this audience have been a glorious part of. Thank you very much.